Want to know about using SmartDeploy to automate PowerShell scripts, or any scripts for that matter, on the endpoints that you manage? Well, you clicked on the right thumbnail. Today, I'm going to show you how to use the remote IT automation feature from SmartDeploy to more efficiently manage your endpoints, whether they're connected to your network or simply connected to the internet. You can do anything from forcing a restart or changing a computer name or collecting and copying logs or whatever PowerShell script you've created. Starting in the application and tasks workspace, let's open the library to see what pre-built packages are already available within SmartDeploy. In addition to a growing list of application packs we create and maintain for our customers, you'll also find common tasks and scripts that you can easily download and deploy to the computers that you manage. Notice this type column, which indicates the type of pack in the library. Let's look at this Activate Windows task. You can see we're just calling some stuff that's already in Windows. You may have run this manually, or you have a batch script saved on your golden reference image, or even put this command in your answer file manually. Well, now you can leave the batch script out of your image and just include this task in your deployment package to let SmartDeploy automate this step for you. We have some handy tasks already created for you, and we're adding to that list all the time. But everyone has unique scripting needs, so let's get into what it looks like to create your own custom task, starting with a batch script. Starting in the application packs workspace, I'll click the plus here and click Create Application Pack. And first, I'll want to save and establish the SPK file by clicking File, New, and then Save the Pack. Next, we'll add some details like the title and versions. Over on the left, you'll see that I can add tasks and files. And for this task, I need to add the batch file first. So I'm going to right-click Files and click Add File. Now we'll add the task to run our batch script. In the navigation pane, we can right-click tasks and take a pause to look at our options and add a run command task. First, I'll select my batch script by clicking Select and then expanding Files and selecting my script file. Now we have to think of this command as if we were running it from a command line. And since it's a batch script, I'll edit this command to add cmd.exe /c in front of the path. And that's it. Let's say I wanted to execute a VBS script. It's going to go a little different. I'll add the VBS script to my files, select my new file in my task, and similar to the batch script, I'll add cscript.exe to the start of the path, just as I would if I were at a command prompt. Now, with PowerShell scripts, there's a little catch. This is because depending on the execution policy on your target, your script may not run if we try and run it like a BAT or VBS script. If you have a PowerShell script, we'll add a little extra syntax to get around that execution policy. Like the other scripts, I'll add the PowerShell script to my files, add a run command task and select my PS1 file, and then add quite a few but necessary arguments. And this is a long one. PowerShell.exe /NoProfile /NonInteractive /ExecutionPolicy /Bypass /File to the beginning of this command and add quotes to my script path. This will allow us to run our PowerShell script. When you have your packs created, you can deploy those independently from computer management by clicking on a computer and selecting Deploy Application. Or you can combine packs, whether applications or tasks, with your image by including them in a deployment package. And once the deployment package is created, select a computer and choose Deploy Image. So there we have it. I hope remote IT automation from SmartDeploy helps you get what you need done with less effort so you can get back to the more strategic and fun part of IT. And you can feel good about making the robots do all the work. If there are any scripts or tasks that you wish were pre-built in the library, please comment below or send your requests to feedback@smartdeploy.com. Thank you for watching. Wait, don't go. We have more videos for you to watch. They're funny and educational. And you don't have to go back to work yet. It'll be great. But I actually do have to go back to work, so I'll see you.